Hello students, today's discussion is on design of plate girder. So what is plate girder and where it is needed? So if we see that plate girder is generally needed in bridges where the spans are high and where the loads are also very high and dynamic in nature. So we have to provide, instead of providing steel beams, we have to provide this girder from pier to pier, and through this girder the load is transferred towards the pier, and from pier it transfers towards the subsoil or foundation soil. So for heavy load and long span, the choice may be of three: either you provide a beam with cover plate or steel truss or plate girders, or two or more rectangular beam. So if we see how it looks like, sometimes we may have to provide cover plates on the girder. This is the plate rolled steel beam. But if the span is such that it's so higher that it cannot be even negotiated with steel rolled steel beam, and also cannot be done with the plated beam or cover plate on the beam that we have discussed in the previous classes, plated beam. Even the span is so higher and the load is such that it cannot be supported by plated beam, then in that case we have to go for plate girder. Or other option may be of truss bridges, where we can see the picture of Bali bridge here, truss bridge. Now, or rectangular, if the span is much more higher, we can go for rectangular girder, where we have to provide a box of steel to provide a girder. But in this present case, we are discussing on the design of this girder, which is plate girder. How it looks like? Actually, if you see, the plate girder is simple beam which is formed by three plates: flange plates and web plates. So we have three components in plate girder. Actually, this is a fabricated thing. The top flange plate, or we may say compression flange plate. This is the tension flange plate, or the bottom flange plate. And we have such members which is termed as stiffeners. We have two types of stiffeners. The stiffener just over the support is known as bearing stiffener, and all other stiffeners are called intermediate stiffeners. So this is a cross section. Some members, which is also near and termed as shear studs, is also provided to have a connection between the RC slab which is crusted over it for the bridge deck, and it should have a good grip between this, so that the shearing of the cover plate, or sorry, the deck slab over the top flange may not occur. That this shearing is resisted by this continuity plate, continuity member, or we may say shear studs. So what are the three components? Number one is flange plates, which actually takes care on the flexure or bending, the web plate, which is generally taken the shear, and the stiffener, which prevents shear buckling. This is a new term, shear buckling, which is to be discussed in this topic. Shear resistance of a stiffened girder. We are discussing on welded plate girder, where the shear resistance is taken by the plate girders. Pre-buckling behavior, stage one. What is that? When the buckling is just at the verge of starting. Requirement of equilibrium in an element inside the square web plate subjected to shear stress result in generation of complementary shear. So what is that? If we see the cross section, this portion, the rectangular plate which is within two stiffeners, which generates complementary shear. What is complementary shear? I'm coming on. Will be resisted. This is the first requirement, and this results to element being subjected to principal compression along the diagonal and tension and the other diagonal. So let us see what happens in this case. if we consider that this is the rectangular portion between two stiffeners here and here, we may say the shear which is here left down, right up in nature, it may be in opposite side, it tries to twist the member, and due to the continuity of the member, there will be a generation of the oppositely directioned shear stress, which is known as complementary shear. So this is the acting shear and this is the complementary shear that will occur. Due to these two, resultant will generate, which will cause a tension in this side, and due to the Poisson's effect, this other two side will try to come down and will cause a compressive stress here. So that is known as compression along the one side and tension along the other side. It will be obviously in an angle of 45 degree, and this is causing tension shear and compressive shear in both of the principal planes. As the applied load is incrementally enhanced, plate will buckle along the direction of the compression or compression diagonal. Corresponding shear stress in the plate is critical shear stress. So when we go on increasing this load, the compressive force will cause a buckling on this side. This, after some time, when it will at the verge of buckling, we will say that the critical stress is generated. So boundary condition is assumed to be simply supported along all the sides of this rectangular plate. So we may see that these are some shear buckling coefficients and all this thing which is mentioned in the code. We may go to IS 800. Here, after checking this d by dw, if it is greater than 67 epsilon, we will decide that okay, the buckling will occur. So if the buckling is occurring, so what will happen? The buckling of the shear buckling will cause a compressive force or in a certain diagonal area, and will cause a failure due to instability or buckling, and that is to be resisted. We have to check the shear. We will say no, Vn is not equals to Vp, it will be V shear. Now that is a critical stress. We say the simple post buckling method. Then we have to go for the checking. We have some provisions here. We'll see that the code has mentioned this factor, which is also termed as KV, shear deformation. What they have mentioned, shear buckling coefficient, and we have to calculate this one, shear buckling coefficient, and the Poisson's ratio. With this, we have to calculate tau shear, the critical shear stress, and with this help, we have to go for non-dimensional slenderness ratio, and on turn we will calculate tau b. This tau b will give us the buckling stress, shear stress corresponding to wave buckling, determined as follows. So this, if tau b is known to us, we have to multiply with it to the shear area, will get the V shear, and then we have to compare the V shear with the V u, the shear occurring on the plate, the maximum shear. And if it is this V shear is greater than this one, V shear will be then transferred to Vd. If the Vd is greater than V shear, then we'll say that the design is, or the it is safe against shear. So this shear buckling phenomena is to be considered in this specially. Next, we have to come to the method of design of stiffener, which is to be discussed on a separate lecture. Thank you. And I hope that the handout note will help you in this case, where you will see that this handout note will be useful for calculation of shear in critical cases. Thank you.